All right, so this is what we got for the day. The bounty is going to finish for the buyers during the day, and we go after new targets on the bounty, most likely 140. All right, so vamos a la zona ya del 1.40 con Libra. Si quiero mantener la compra, lo puedo hacer. En intradía, cierro la posición. So, yeah, you either want to. The pound dollar will end up for the buyers, all right? End up for buyers today. Va a terminar para los compradores la libra, solamente. Entonces, si quiero comprar de nuevo, lo hago en 39.88 hasta la zona, repito, de 1.40. Cerca de 1.40 ya cierro. So, if you want to buy again the pound dollar, you do it from 39.88 up to 140 level, okay? Yeah, it's going to continue. Va a continuar subiendo, así como está. No hay ventas. Eurodólar está entrando a precio comprador. No logramos comprar hoy. Así que vamos a esperar que recupere algo del drawdown sufrido el día de hoy. De 23.47 sería comprador hasta 23.65 y 23.80. So the Eurodólar we could not buy today. We're going after this little price right here. So we got 123.47, 123.65, and thank you. And lastly, 123.80. Okay, so those are the buy prices and targets for the euro. Son los precios y targets para el euro. Okay, like I said, there's no sellers at the euro, only buyers. But in order to buy, you'd rather wait. Okay, para comprar en euros, mejor esperar un poquito más. Y entrar con seguridad los intervalos que mencionamos en su momento. Dólar yen hoy se vendió, tenemos un pequeño retroceso. Si dólar yen sube, nos conviene vender, ¿okay? La estrategia es venta en dólar yen. So the first sale price on dólar yen is 106.06, and then you take this little range, ¿okay? But do not try to sell now, of course. No vendo acá, vendo acá, de acá hasta acá. All right. So if you want to sell dollar yen, then like I said, you wait for 106.06 and then you take the range down to here. That's the range that we did today. Y el oro se queda vendido durante el día de hoy. The gold is going to end up for the sellers. And we sold today, but I wouldn't recommend to sell. The price is going to try to move up a little bit here with gold. And as long as goes up, then you wait for sale prices, but there's no buyers with gold, okay? No hay ningún tipo de compra con el oro, sino que el precio sube y espero para vender. Y lo que nos sorprendió el día de hoy, el dólar CAD, estamos con el primer día en punto de reversión. Dólar canadiense estaría atravesando una reversión en donde arriba de 1.30 se dirige a la zona de compra del 1.36. Y este es el primer día. Necesitamos que mañana se mantenga arriba de 1.30 y el lunes se mantenga arriba de 1.30. Eso significa, bien sabemos, para price action, reversión de área de mercado, pasando de la zona de venta a la zona de compra. So, the dollar CAD is the rockstar of the day. It's about to change the market area. And we need today to be kept above the 1.30. If today makes it, it's the market is holding about 1.30 tomorrow and on Monday, that is the behavior that we need, and that's all we need to know to understand the dollar CAD is about to change the market areas from the sell market area up to the buyer's market area. That is from 1.30 up to 1.36, and that means also long-term strategy for dollar CAD. Okay, so that's the good news of the day. But of course, for the rest, we keep everything the way it goes. Euro dollar buy pressure area, pound dollar buy pressure area, dollar yen sell pressure area, and gold is also into buy pressure area, but after sell prices. Okay, todo el resto se mantiene igual. El dólar CAD es el único que necesitamos que el mercado se mantenga. Compra el día de hoy, compra mañana y el día martes, y ya es un comportamiento que vamos a aprovechar para largo plazo con dólar CAD. Eso es todo por hoy. Continuamos mañana. That's all we got for today. Let's continue.